In this class, I am going to discuss multiplication of a vector, and multiplication of a vector has two types, that is dot product and cross product. Let's see what is a dot product. Dot product is also called as scalar product. The reason why we call dot product as scalar product because the resultant that we get after the scalar product is a scalar quantity, that is, it doesn't have any direction. So let me explain this. Now we have two vectors. Let me take this vector to be b bar and this point to be O, and let's take this another vector a bar. A bar is making an angle theta with b bar. Now if I am asked to find the dot product of these two vectors, that is a bar dot b bar, the value you get it to be magnitude of a bar into magnitude of b bar and cosine of the angle between the two vectors. So this is the basic formula for dot product or scalar product, that is a bar dot the dot product b bar is equal to magnitude of a bar into magnitude of b bar and cosine of the angle between the two vectors. Now let me illustrate this concept with the help of an example. So here I have a ground, it's a plane ground. Let this point be A, let this point be B, and let this point be C. Now I'm placing a toy here. Let this be a toy, it's a toy, and a boy is standing at point B, and the boy is holding onto the toy with the help of a rope, and this rope is making an angle theta with the ground. Now how should I apply this dot product concept into this particular scenario? That is, if I want to find the work done by this boy in moving the toy from point A to C, that is, he should move this toy from point A to C. To do that, he needs to pull this toy in a direction. As you can see, he'll be applying the force on the toy in the direction along the thread. That is, the thread is the direction in which the force will be applied, and the direction in which the toy moves is the displacement of the toy. So if I want to find the work done by the boy in moving the toy from point A to C, you use the concept of dot product. Now I'll be calculating the work done by the boy in moving this toy from A to C. So work done is given by F bar dot S bar. What is this F bar? F bar is a force in which the boy is pulling the toy, that is the direction. This force is making an angle theta with the horizontal. This is the force in which the boy is applying, and it is making an angle theta with the horizontal, that is the displacement. So F bar dot S bar is the formula of dot product, and the resultant will be magnitude of F bar into magnitude of S bar into cos of the angle between the two vectors, that is displacement vector and force vector. So this is the basic theory behind the dot product. Now let's discuss vector product or cross product. Let me take a vector A bar and B bar. They are making an angle theta. So A bar and B bar are making an angle theta between them. Now as per the formula of cross product, you can take it as A bar cross B bar is equal to magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sine of the angle between the two vectors. That is, the magnitude, the effect of A bar into B bar is equal to magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sine of the angle between the two vectors. Now in which direction will this effect will be felt? To know that A bar, B bar, and the effect will be in a direction perpendicular to the plane consisting of the two vectors. That is, let this vector be C bar. That is, A bar cross B bar is equal to C bar. C bar is in the direction perpendicular to the plane consisting of A bar and B bar. Let me illustrate this with the help of an example. Now I have a wall here, it's a wall, and I want to insert a screw into the wall. Let this be a screw. So if I want to insert the screw into the wall, I need to rotate the screw. Let this point be A and this point be B. If I move the screw from point A to B, means I rotate it from point A to B, what happens? You can see the screw getting inside the wall, means it will be inserted into the wall. That means the motion of the screw is towards the wall. When I'm rotating in a direction, you can see when I'm moving from point A to B, the effect is felt inside the wall. That is, you can see, let's take the example here. Let me take this as a screw. If I'm rotating from point A to point B, what happens? You can see the screw gets inserted in the direction perpendicular to the plane consisting of vector A and A bar and B bar. That is, the plane consisting of A bar and B bar is the top surface of the screw, and the effect is felt in the direction towards the wall. So let us discuss the properties of dot product and cross product. So the first property is dot product is commutative. That is, A bar dot B bar is equal to B bar dot A bar. That is the magnitude that we obtain after applying A bar dot B bar is equal to the magnitude of B bar dot A bar. Similarly, coming to the cross product, it is not commutative. That is, it is not commutative. That is, A bar cross B bar is not equal to the value that we get after applying B bar dot B bar cross A bar. That is, A bar cross B bar is not equal to B bar cross A bar. But A bar cross B bar is equal to minus of B bar into A bar. So cross product exhibits anti-commutative property. So coming to the dot product is distributive. That is, A bar dot B bar plus C bar is equal to A bar dot B bar, so the magnitude, plus A bar dot C bar. Similarly, cross product is distributive. It's similar to the dot product, where A bar cross B bar is equal to A bar cross B bar plus A bar cross C bar. The third property is dot product of two perpendicular vectors is zero. That is, A bar dot B bar is equal to magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar and cosine of the angle between the two vectors. And you can see I'm taking two vectors A bar and B bar, and they are making an angle 90 degrees, and cos 90 is zero, so you get the final value to be zero. Similarly, coming to the cross product of two perpendicular vectors, it is equal to their magnitudes. That is, A bar cross B bar is equal to magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar and sine 90 degrees. And here An indicates the direction in which the effect of A bar and B bar will be felt. In this case, you can see I'm taking two vectors A bar and B bar, and they are making an angle 90 degrees. The effect of it will be felt in the direction perpendicular to the base where these two vectors are present. That is, C bar is what I am taking, and it is perpendicular to A bar and B bar. And similarly, let's see this dot product of two parallel vectors or anti-parallel. That is, parallel means they are in the same direction, anti-parallel means they are in the opposite direction. So here the angle is 0 degrees, here the angle is 180 degrees. So let's see what happens. So A bar dot B bar is equal to magnitude into cosine of the angle 0. So it is cosine, cos 0 is 1, and you get AB. And here A bar dot B bar is equal to AB cos 180 degrees. As cos 180 degrees minus 1, you get minus AB. Now let's see the fourth property here. Cos product of two parallel vector is 0. That is, A bar dot B bar is equal to magnitude of A bar into B bar and cosine of the angle 0. And it turns out to be 0 because cos sine 0 is 0. Now let's discuss the Now let us see the fourth property. Cross product of two parallel vectors is 0. Here you can see A bar dot B bar is equal to A bar into B bar, or the magnitude of A bar into B bar, and sine of the angle between the two vectors. Here it is 0, so they are not making any angle. So sine 0 is 0, and the final result is 0. Now we'll see the fifth property. Dot product of itself is equal to square of its magnitude. So here A bar dot A bar gives A bar magnitude of A bar into magnitude of A bar, that is A into A, cos 0 is A square. Here cos 0 is 1, and you get A square. Now let's see cross product of any vector with itself is 0, that is A bar cross A bar, where it's A into A into sine 0. Sine 0 is 0, and you get A into A into 0 is 0. Let's see the dot product of orthogonal unit vectors. That is, all these vectors are 90 degrees. And here you can see ijk, we have discussed in our previous videos, where ijk is the standard symbol we use for unit vector, presenting unit vector, where unit vector has a magnitude of 1 and it gives the direction of any particular vector. So here I into I is equal to j into j is equal to k into k gives 1, and similarly I into j into k is equal to k into I gives 0. This is because k into k, they're parallel vectors. It's similar to this, like cos 0, and here they make cos 90. Cos 90 is 0, so finally the result is 0. Similar case applies to this, these vectors as well, because commutative property is followed by dot product. Now coming to cross product. Cross product of orthogonal unit vectors is I into I is equal to j cross j, or I cross I is equal to j cross j is equal to k cross k is equal to 0. Here sine theta is equal to 0, so you get 0 value. And coming to this, I cross J is equal to K bar. Here J cross K is equal to I bar. K cross I is equal to J bar. Now in cross product of orthogonal unit vectors, you can see cross product of orthogonal unit vectors. Let's see the sixth property. Cross product of orthogonal unit vectors, I bar cross I bar is equal to J bar cross J bar is equal to K bar cross K bar is equal to 0. Why is it 0? Because it's sine 0. And in this case, I cross J bar is equal to K bar. You can see a pattern. I cross J bar is equal to K bar. J bar cross K bar is equal to I bar. K bar cross I bar is equal to J bar. That means a pattern is followed. Since cross product follows anti-commutative property, if you reverse the order, I bar cross K bar, you get minus J bar. Similarly, K bar cross J bar, we get minus I bar. So J bar cross I bar. So if I am reversing it, I'll be getting minus K bar. And you can see I bar cross K bar is minus J bar. So it is following anti-commutative property. That is, cross product do not adhere to commutative law. Now let's see the next property. The seventh property is the of dot product is representation of dot product in Cartesian coordinate system. Here I am taking two vectors, A bar dot B bar, where A bar is represented as AX I bar plus AY J bar plus AZ K bar dot BX I bar plus BY J bar plus BZ K bar. Now if I am asked to find A bar dot B bar, so I calculate AX is the magnitude of A bar in the x direction or the I direction. So I multiply it, AX, BX, the magnitudes in the x direction, into I dot into I. That means I into I gives rise to 1. That is, we have already discussed, because I dot I is 1 and J dot J is 1 and K dot K is 1, as we have already discussed. So AX, BX remains here. Then we take the next value, AX into BY, and here I dot J is 0, as we have already discussed. Then similarly, so this gets cancelled up. So this gets cancelled. So AX, BZ, I dot K is again it's 0. Here again you can see J dot I is 0. J into J, here it is 1. J into J is 1, so AY, BY remains. So here again you can see AY, BZ. So here it gets cancelled. So AZ, BX, so here K into I is 0, so it gets cancelled up, it becomes 0. AZ, BY, it is K into J, again it's 0. What is remaining? AZ, BZ, that is because it is K into K is 1. Similarly, looking at the Cartesian coordinate system of cross product, A bar dot B bar is, as usual, it is written in vector format, IJK format. And here we calculate the value using determinant method of matrix, where I write I, J, K, AX, AY, AZ, BX, BY, BZ. Then I take I here, I, then I cross multiply AY, BZ minus AZ, BY. And again in the matrix form, the second part is minus, I keep here. Then we take the J bar, then we take the J here, AX, BZ, you take the cross multiplication, AX, BZ, AZ, BY. minus az by. And here k bar we take there, and you take it as ax by minus by ay. That is a cross multiplication that we do to find the value of cross product in a Cartesian coordinate system. So these are the properties we have discussed. Now let's go to the next topic.